was no reason to shoot them. There was no reason. He took away four lives. He took away a young girl. He took away my daughter, who has two girls. And she was just going to get married. She was happy. And there was no reason for this.
Police say suspect David Laffer and his wife were high on prescription drugs when arrested. Nationwide, drugstore robberies are up 81% in the last 5 years. That figure mirrors the growth in prescription drug abuse, with painkillers like Vicodin, OxyContin, and Valium becoming the second most abused drugs behind marijuana.
Many people become addicted to painkillers when they start taking them for legitimate reasons, like after surgery. They make you feel euphoric, but it quickly takes more of the drug to get that same feeling. And withdrawal can be very unpleasant.
Pain relief is big business here, with Americans gobbling up most of the world's supply. The bigger problem? A whopping 70% of painkillers are taken by someone other than the person whose name is on the prescription. Congress is addressing this by considering legislation to increase regulations that would make it harder for people to get drugs from different doctors and pharmacies that don't communicate with each other, to reclassify some painkillers, making them more difficult to prescribe, and to impose stricter penalties for doctors who write illegal prescriptions and for people who steal the drugs.
One-third of teens believe there's nothing wrong with using prescription drugs which are not meant for them every once in a while. That's a problem.
It just kind of just slows everything down. Makes you not feel as much.
It feels like almost nothing can hurt you. Like what's going on in reality doesn't affect you.
Yeah, you could have girl problems or problems at home that you just can't deal with anymore.
They just want to hide from their problems, so they take the pills.
According to the DEA, prescription drug parties are a frightening fad.
And when they walk through the door, everyone turns in whatever pills they have accumulated in the course of time, put it in a fishbowl, and during the night they take a handful of pills, drink alcohol behind it, and unfortunately many of them overdose, and sadly enough some go to bed and never wake up.
They're called farm parties, and much of the drugs come from regular homes. Kids often raid their parents' medicine cabinet without anybody even knowing the drugs are gone.
To prevent this from happening, keep your prescriptions in a secure place and get rid of the ones you no longer take.
Expired prescriptions can be dangerous, even if they're yours.
You just can't guarantee what it's going to do to you, and you don't know how it's going to affect your body. You don't know how it's going to affect the rest of the other medications you might be taking.
So what's the best way to get rid of your unused medicine?
Our problem is folks don't know what to do with all the medicine sitting in their cabinets. And they look around and decide, well, and often doctors have told them this, to just dump it into the toilet, flush it away. And that way it's no longer a danger for them or for someone getting into it. But no one thought through that, where does it go after that?
Unfortunately, it goes into a wastewater treatment plant that's not designed to get the drugs out of the water. In fact, scientists have detected high levels of pharmaceutical compounds in some drinking water sources. Throwing drugs in the garbage also harms the environment, so the safest route is to drop off your unused drugs at a take-back event held by the DEA and local police departments throughout the year.
In my area of responsibility, we collected over 18,500 pounds of pharmaceutical drugs. So are they successful? Absolutely.
Or you can safely send your pills to a drug disposal company. You can buy this kit at your local pharmacy. Just fill the prepaid envelope and drop it in a mailbox. So while law enforcement and Washington try to reduce the prescription drug abuse epidemic, there are steps we can take right now to stop a potential problem before it starts. Lori Johnson, CBN News.